When I was 8 years old, ever since then I've been here in Las Vegas. I did my school here. And something that I really identified with Jose from the movie was where he's Skyping with his mother. I haven't seen my mother, and it's going to be 3 years now. And I completely understand that feeling of not wanting to speak to her, but at the same time you want to. It's really hard. And it's also very hard going through school and being with your friends, and everybody's, you know, saying, oh, well, I'm going to get my driver's license next month, or I already applied for a job. When are you going to do it? And all you say is, oh, you know, soon, eventually. And you don't want to really say, oh, I can't do it. You know, I don't have the paperwork. I can't. I'm not like you. And it's really hard knowing that everybody's moving on, and you're just stuck in that place. But, which is why we all need to keep fighting for this. And I mean, like he said, this isn't a movie. Like she said, I mean, we're not a movie. We're actually real people going through this. And just don't forget that. That's it. Bravo.
Hi, how are you? So my name is Alan Aleman. I was one of the first dreamers to get DACA here in the state of Nevada. And I think most of us can identify with Jose. I think the fact that, you know, there's a lot of people that don't qualify for DACA just for it can be, you know, one day or even hours. And I think that's the reason why we need immigration reform, not only for us, but for our parents. I came to the U.S. when I was 11 with my parents and my sister, and you know a lot of the politicians blamed our parents for this, but I don't blame my parents for trying to make to offer us a better life. Instead of blaming them, I thank them every day because thanks to the decision they made, I'm the person I am today. I'm getting closer to graduation. I'm graduating from CSN, and one of my biggest dreams is to be a doctor here in the state of Nevada because Nevada needs doctors. So I think a lot of people are, you know, hearing stories from, you know, from the House of Representatives saying, you know, that the immigration reform is dead. But I think we should, you know, have hope and keep pushing the GOP, and I'm sure something's going on. So you hear people, you know, saying the immigration reform is not happening. You know, don't let them, you know, put you down. Instead, fight for immigration reform and encourage other people to do the same thing. So thank you.